Well, hello
everyone.
And welcome back to our channel. My name is Felicia X.
Mark Midnight. Blessed be. Blessed be. We are going to listen to my favorite songs from 1997. Now, it went to a top 15 from last year's 1996 top 10, and if you haven't seen it, please look it up, because there were so many songs that I loved in 1997 that I went for a top 15. Now, this is the year that I went from Canada, early in Canada, in Victoria, BC, and I went to Adelaide, Australia. So it's a mix between Canadian songs and Australian songs that were on the radio at the time back then that were popular. So that's the information you need to understand why I chose these songs. So here we go, let's crack on, get into it. All right, so this song is the number 15 song. It's called Coma by Pendulum. Yeah, it's a different version. It doesn't sound anything like the one I like. The problem is that back in 1997, you don't have the internet. So this is as close we can get to, this is it actually. But again, these songs are hard to find. I mean, if they're not hugely popular, but I like the sound of it, like the ding, 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 ding. So the number 14 song of 1997 for me is a song by Faithless called Insomnia. Again, another kind of just music, mostly. I remember it being like the whole, I can't get no sleep. You probably heard this before.
No.
Really? So good. I think, feel like this was like a change in music. Like, it started to get more electronic, kind of like really cool. No idea. And again, I don't care. I don't think about it as much as you do. I don't think about the words. I don't think about the artist. Now, number 13, we have Pet Shop Boys, who I love, of course. Now, this is different because this Pet Shop Boys song is not one of their biggest, most popular songs. But there is something about it. I just loved it. It was really, I like the fact it's not one of their most popular songs, actually. Sometimes I can't tell you why I like them, I just like the feel of it. Here it comes. Typical Pet Shop Boys, you must admit. Oh, my smile! Oh my god. I really like the Red Letter Day. And not that many people like or know it, I should say. Here it comes again. Oh, I want. Now, number 12. I know you're gonna love this.
But Girl.
They just came out this year, 1997. They didn't come out as gay. I mean, they just came out. You know, it's Aqua. And I'm surprised when I listen back that I love this so much that it was in my top songs, but I guess it was so different when it came out. Yeah, when it came out.
It's stupid, but it's a good song.
It is stupid.
It reminds me of Kino.
Yes, and because now you've got like Kino and from Norway that we love, but this is back in 97, so it's a long time ago. But they paved the way, I think, for like a bit silly kind of. Kino's a bit more serious than them, though.
Yeah.
But yeah. A Canadian Shania Twain.
And it's, oh my girl, Shania.
Home ain't where his heart is anymore. So we've changed a little bit here. I've gone a little country rock-ish. Country, almost. I actually love this song. I mean, yeah. I almost feel like I went back to Australia for this year, 97, and I miss Canada. So for me, it kind of hit me. It's like, oh wow. Canadian singer, and love this song.
We don't feel the same since our life began.
I mean, it's a lovely song, isn't it? No complaints with this one. So we like this song, right? You like it? Not a big fan of this song. I don't know why I like it so much. I think
it's cute.
I think I like it just because it had that emotional connection for me. I like the feel of it. I like the harmonies. I love the harmonies. And the fact I was back in Australia and I kind of miss Canada. So I don't know. I think maybe that's what it was. So number 10, that would just miss out on the top 10. Number 10, we're gonna go back to DJ Bobo, I'm sorry. If we've gone back to the band that I love, DJ Bobo, Respect Yourself by DJ Bobo. I love this song too. Obviously, it made my top 10 at number 10. Don't know what you don't know. Colors of the rainbow. And you will find a way. Respect yourself. And you will find a way. It's got a good mix of like a little bit of rap sort of with his, you know. And it's like bassy. So we like this. Number 10, not bad for a top 10. All right, thank you very much. So that was number 10. So at number 9, we've gone Hanson. I don't know.
Hanson.
You remember Hanson? I will come to you. They were so cute. All the family, the brothers, right? The Hanson brothers. I remember this. I remember listening to it, going to the aquatic center in Adelaide. I don't know why it came out, and I'm like,
why are you doing the aquatic center? Like
swimming
with like dolphins and seals?
No, it's aquatic. It's called the aquatic center. You go swimming, you do laps. But music does that, right? It brings back memories. I'm like, yeah, I used to like drive to the aquatic center and swim laps. But I remember this song specifically. I loved it right at that time that I started to do that for a few months. I don't know. It's weird.
Okay.
And it was an interesting time for me. Sad side is shining. It's a really good song. The Brothers Hanson.
I like this song.
Well, there we are. That's the number 9 song. For 1997. This is a number 8 song of the year.
Oh, Guns N' Roses?
No.
Or you, the Metallica?
I understand you would say that, but this is Daniel Johns from Silverchair. Massive Australian band. Silverchair were massive around the world, in fact, back in 97. This song called Cemetery. Really different for me to like this, but firstly, he's a nice looking guy, but the song is the cemetery. Morning is living. I live in a cemetery. I mean, it's a bit different for me, isn't it, to have this in my top? But then we change it up completely and go all theatrical and go with the Evita movie and Madonna.
You must love me.
Nope. This is I'd Be Surprisingly Good For You. I loved this one more. I love you must love me too. I agree with you, actually. And to be honest, when I look back, I go, why didn't I have that in here? But this, I don't know. I don't know why. This one just got me. There's nothing calculated, nothing planned. Please forgive me if I seem naive. Ding, 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 ding. A frantic tumble and a shy goodbye. This movie was so good. It's actually, it's interesting looking at it back again and going, everything about it, like all the songs are great. Probably my favorite musical of all time. I don't really like
the
musicals.
The Madonna one though.
Yeah, Madonna, oh yeah, yeah, this yeah. actual movie, Evita by Madonna.
Yeah.
So this group is called Delirium. They're a Canadian and this song is called Firefly. It had such a sound to it, like amazing. Love this. A worthy top five. Should be number one, really. Or close. Here it comes.
Madonna's erotic album.
Yes, it sounds like it. It was probably the same time, isn't it? No, it's a bit later. I never thought of you. Which I love, the album. Must admit, that's pretty cool. Great sound. Again, we were talking about like mid to late 90s. And they've got this amazing sound. Yeah. So good. So on that theme or that sound and that feel, we're gonna go with Robert Miles, because Robert Miles is also quite electronic, and the song is called One and One, and I love this. Obviously it's my number four song of the year from 1997. This kind of music, the last two songs, you want to crank it, make it loud, have the bass, have the feel of it, the sound of it. Always you. This even has harmonies. Always mine. After all said and done, one and one. We need love, we need love. The whole feel of this year, you must admit, is kind of like this for me. Kavana, I can make you feel good. Now, I mean, I think mostly I liked it because I like the look of the guy, first of all, back in 97. I was obsessed with him and his song. I can make you feel good. Yeah, I can make you feel good. Say you really want you. This is number three, and it's quite funny because this is a song that most people, a lot of people love and a lot of people hate. You either love it or you hate it or you're sick of it. We have to understand, this is back in 1997. The song came out with the movie, which I love the movie. And it's the Canadian Celine Dion with My Heart Goes. It is a great song though.
Amazing.
There's no doubting the fact that this is an amazing song.
Amazing.
It's just overplayed, but who cares? It's a great song. I still like listening to it. But I feel like for me, it gets to my higher number because I was going through things. I was about to leave my country forever and move to Canada. And I don't know, I feel like it had something to do with it. Just my opinion. It is the Crash Test Dummies, another Canadian band. And this is Superman's song. This song is so good. When I heard this, I'm like, oh my God. Wasn't a ladies' man. The voice, the everything about it, it just hits me. I like get chills when I hear it.
good though.
Superman never made any money.
Crumbled, but Superman, he forced himself to
carry on. Keep Krypton going. I mean, it's a bit stupid, it's super bad, but
I like it.
It's such a
I
good
like
song.
I like it a lot.
Well, thank you very much.
A lot. I like it a lot.
Thank the Lord! Finally, we get to number one, which is, of course, and it has to be, I don't know what it has to be, just George Michael. And I can't make you love me. I don't know. I can't explain why that this is my number one, but it's emotional. It's just a great song. I love the sound of it. I love his voice.
You like song that you like.
And then it's just like, it's. I remember where I was when I first heard it. And then I'm like, and I remember where I was walking when I heard this song in. I can make you love me if you want. You can fake your love. And it's weird because I normally don't listen to words, but I feel it from George. Like the way he sings, like I feel his emotion in it. And I was going through a stage where 97 was like, do I leave my country of birth for somebody? Which is exactly what happened. I left for a Canadian. I left my country I loved, Australia, and I moved to Canada for that person. And I don't know, just the emotion of this song and the timing of it is like, oh, really? And that is it, really. That was my 1997 top 15.
Are you still happy with your decisions?
I am, actually. I am. When I think about going back to them, I am. And what's your point, your feeling about this?
I would put Celine number one.
Really?
But that song is
Yeah, but
insane.
It didn't have
that song is insane.
I agree, but it didn't have the same emotional connection to me from where I was in my life at the time.
That Celine song is probably her most famous song.
I agree.
And
yeah,
even and, though it's and been I love overplayed,
it. Yeah,
and it's just that song is insane.
I agree. It's really good.
That song is insane.
It is really good. But let's not look at it like what is the best song in my list. What is the best song that's done as well? But I'm just saying that this choice is just because of I went through, and it didn't quite get there emotionally for me like the other two.
Yep.
Song's dead.
I agree with that.
But number three, yes. It
you
deserves
know what?
To be there.
It could be a really bad song.
And it still doesn't matter because it's
if
about me.
But you're emotionally attached to it,
yep.
There's no judgment on that, right?
Yeah, it's my own personal
feeling. I could play you a song.
Feeling.
Me,
yeah.
About burros and chickens.
Burros.
And you might be like, what the actual fuck?
You mean burros as in burritos
me?
Or the
burros,
donkeys?
Like, donkeys, yes.
Oh, yeah.
But if I feel attached to that, you cannot change that, right?
It's exactly right.
Yes.
Yeah, it's what you're going
yes.
through at the time
yes.
and what you're feeling.
Yes.
And yeah. Well, I'm glad that you understand that that's
of course I get that.
That's what it was all about. It's
yes.
not about the best song here. It's
I'm
about what
you
I was going through.
From these lists.
There you go. Well, there we are. Now, that is just our
opinion
and essay about this. And thank you for watching. And
later.
Hanging out. Adios.